Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create this weekly habit planner in Word. So the first thing I'm going to do is insert a table. So for this, I'm just going to choose one row and 9 columns. And why I'm going to do that is because I'm going to customize this row and then duplicate it. But before I do that, my cursor's in the left-hand cell. I'm just going to press my return key twice. That just enables me to go back up here and place in a title. So unfortunately, my screen capture program failed me at this point and my cursor's disappeared. So what I'm actually doing at this point is hovering my cursor over the vertical lines and pulling them over to the right. Your cursor should look like this. And what you need to do is pull those lines over so you've got enough room on the left-hand side to write in your habit, and then a small gap for a space, and then we'll have 7 equal cells on the right-hand side. Okay, so I'm going to leave my space to be about this big here. Now, to ensure my days of the week are all evenly distributed, I'm going to select those 7 rows, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, yep. Go to layout, and then go down to distribute columns here and click. And you can see now they've all been distributed equally. The next thing I want to do is just to take out the line at the top here and the line at the bottom here in this cell. So I'm going to click on this cell. I'm going to go to table design, and I'm going to go to borders here. I'm going to click on the drop down, and then I'm going to take out the top border here. Now, this might take out the entire top border. So if I click on this, no, it's only taken out that cell. Great. So then click on the drop down again and go to bottom border. And you can see now I've made a nice space between my habit and my days of the week. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate this row here. If I put my cursor at the end here in the far right hand cell and then press my tab key, do that again, place the cursor here and press the tab key again. I'm going to do that 7 times. There we go. And the top here I'm going to use as my hobbies title. I'm going to select the text, go to the home tab. I'm going to change the font to Amatic. Then I'm going to put it into bold. Then I'm going to increase the font size to 24. And then I'm going to center it using this center text icon here. And then in these cells, I'm going to do exactly the same. I'm going to first of all just type in the letters of the days of the week. Now you can see they're all at the top of the cell here. I want to move them to the bottom. So select them all, go to layout, go to these icons here, and at the bottom you can see align to bottom center. Click on that and they'll all be aligned to the bottom. Again, I'm going to go back to the home tab, and then I'm going to change my font size and my font. Let's just change that to bold and down to 24. There we go. Perfect. Now for the top row here, I'm going to take out most of the lines except for the bottom one. So select the whole of that row, go to table design and along to borders. So I'm going to take out the left borders and the right borders, the top border, and then also the borders inside, those vertical borders inside. Now you can see the top border hasn't come off here. So I'm going to select it again, go back up and uncheck top border again. Let's do that again with these. Click on top border. There we go, and it's disappeared. So now we've got that table into our document. We're going to duplicate it, but the first thing we need to do is just select it all, go to layout and go to height. I'm going to change the height of this to 1 centimeter. And that will allow you to write or type your text in, give you a little bit more space. You can make them wider if you want to. You can make them taller if you want to, but it's completely up to you. You can just see that the text icon here is at the top. So if I was to type, all that text would go to the top. Again, you can select all of those cells, and then you can choose where your text lies when you type. So if you were to choose the bottom left, and then type, you can see where your text would be. Once you're happy with that, I'm going to go to the bottom of the table, place my cursor and then press return. And that should mean that when I copy and paste this table, the table will end up on this row here. So select the table, copy it, Command or Control C, and then place the cursor down here, Command or Control V. So the reason I've done this is because on this piece of paper, it can give you 2 weeks worth of habits. You don't have to, you can just have more habits if you want to, and you can just have more rows, it's completely up to you. But this is a way that you can have to. You can have three on here as well, but I'm just gonna put a little notes box down here. I'm gonna put a title and some design in, as you could see at the beginning. Now, if I was to insert a table down here, I could change the size of it, but I'd find it very difficult to move it to exactly where I want it. So I'm going to insert a text box. Go to Insert, Text Box, click on the drop down and select Draw Text Box. Click and draw out a text box. Don't worry too much about how big it is, but put it roughly where you want it in your design. So I'm going to have it round about here. Perfect. Double click inside, make sure your cursor's there. Go to Insert, Table, click on the drop down, and I'm going to select 5 rows. Now you can see your table's been inserted, and if I deselect it, reselect it, I can then move it wherever I want to in my document. Now I'm going to select this table and make those rows a bit taller. Go to Layout, go to Height, and then I'm going to change that to 1 centimeter. And then I'm going to put my text at the bottom left. Now you can see we've also got this black line that's running around the outside, which I don't want. So select the text box, go to Format Shape, go to Shape Outline, click on the drop down and select No Outline. So I'm just going to move that down a bit. And the reason for that is I'm going to move these two tables down. I've put my cursor at the top here. I'm just going to move all of this down so I can get the heading in. I can move this up. There we go. And now I'm going to place in the heading. So go to Home, and then I'm going to go to Center Text. Select my text. Again, I'm going to change the font to Amatic. I'm going to change the size to 48. Put that in bold and also underline. I just need to bring the tables back up. So you can see there's a bit of a gap between the two here. So I'm going to place my cursor and just press the delete key and move that up. If you wanted the title further up the page, you can just go over to the rulers. If you can't see the rulers, go to View and make sure rulers is checked. Go over here and click between the gray and the white section. Click and just move that up, and then you can move the whole of your design up as well. And then just press the return key. You can see this gap's huge because the font is huge. So if you want to decrease this gap, Home tab, and just simply change the font size. There you go, and it's much smaller. Okay, and now for some graphics. So the way I've created those graphics, go to Insert, Shapes, and then I've used this icon here. It's called Curve. Just click on it. All you need to do is just click, click, click. Just click around to make any random shape, and then just join it at the end there, and then you can make this slightly ambiguous shape. You can use the rotation icon there to rotate it around, and then you can also move it, stretch it, whatever you like. So place that there, and then I'm going to go up to Shape Format. I'm going to get rid of the outline because I don't want an outline, but I am going to change the color. So click on the drop down. I'm going to go down to More Fill Colors. And on my color wheel, I want to select a slightly dusky pink. So around about there. The color I'm choosing, I'm just moving this cursor around here, and the color I choose ends up in this box here. So as you see, as I move this around, that color in the box changes. So I'm going to go for something around about here, and then just click OK. So once you're happy, I'm going to copy and paste this. You can make another shape and go through the same process, but I'm just going to hold down my Alt or Option key, click and drag out another shape. And the reason for that is because if I then go to Shape Format, I can go to this icon here that says Edit Shape. Go down to Edit Points, and this will allow me to actually click on these black points and pull and push the size of this shape and actually create something that's completely different. I can also get rid of them. So if I hold down my control key and click, it will actually get rid of it. Or I can go back, Command or Control Z. So you can really create something unique and also completely different. So once you're happy, just press Enter and then just move the shape up to the corner. Let's just rotate that. And now we're just going to add a little bit of interest. So we're going to go onto the internet and go to this website here called pixabay.com. You can see it at the top here. In the search bar here, I'm going to type leaves foliage. And then I'm going to click on this drop down and go to illustrations. Then at the top here where it says color, I'm going to go to black and white and click go. And then I've got a whole range of different options to choose from that I can place in my design. Now the design I used isn't there, so I'm going to take out foliage and press enter again. If you can't see something you like, click on next page. So I want to select this one. So once you've clicked on it, just go to the free download, select which option you want and click download. Then go back to Word, then go to insert, picture, click on the drop down, picture from file, go to the downloads, click on the top file here, herbs, and click insert. Now don't worry, when this happens, everyone goes a bit bonkers because it's just wrecked their design, but don't panic. Select your image, right click on it, go down to wrap text and go down to in front of text. And the next thing we want to do, so you can move this anywhere you like, it hasn't destroyed your design. So we want two designs, one at the bottom, one at the top. So I need to copy and paste this image. So all I'm going to do is select it, hold down my Alt or Option key, click and drag. So for the design down here, I'm going to go to picture format and go to crop. Once I select crop, you can see I've got these black markers around the outside. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to choose this one here. So I'm going to crop everything else out. Just like that and press enter. And then I'm just left with this design here. And then I can just pop it wherever I like and resize it. Whoops, that happens. Just press Command or Control Z to go back. There we go. And for this design here, I want to select this one. So again, go to picture format, crop, and then I'm going to crop everything else out. Press enter, use the rotation icon, pop that up there for a perfect design. So once you're happy with that, you can either use that digitally if you want to, or you can simply print it out. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.